Welcome back, and now we shall start learning the movement of each of the chessmen as to how these six type of chessmen, as to how they move and how they capture and what is their importance. So let us start with the rook. In medieval Satranj, the rook symbolized the chariot, and the Persian word rook means chariot, and the corresponding piece in the Indian version of Chaturanga has the name Rath. So you know, like we used to call it Rath in the medieval war, and in modern times it is known as, you know, like Hathi, we call it Hathi, elephant by the olden name. And now we come to its movement. How does a rook move? Well, the movement of rook is very easy to remember. It's a straight line piece, so it moves only in a straight line to any of the vacant square, means either horizontally or vertically. We also call it standing and sleeping in either direction unless its path is obstructed. So let us see this rook here, which is standing on one of this square here, and how does it move? Well, it can move up vertically this way to any of the vacant square. Here the board is totally vacant, so yes, this choice. And also it can like move downwards vertically and then horizontally on this empty square. And like, if you can see this, that what are the choices available to the rook in this position, so we can see that it can go to any of this 14 square. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, that is 7 square vertically or standing, and then 8 9 10 11 12 13 14, and 7 squares horizontally or sleeping. It means here the rook has a choice of moving to any of the 14 squares. Going ahead, we have learned that, you know, like rook can only go as far as it is not obstructed, but it does not have power to jump. As such, here you can see, like this rook, it can only move in a straight line vertically, but it does not have power to move horizontally. Why? Because you can see that it is obstructed by his own king. That means here rook has a choice of only 7 squares. And like, you can try moving to any of the square. You can either go here or here, it is up to you, but only on this line. You does not have power to like come over the king, jump over the king. So a very simple thing to remember, rook does not have jumping power. It can only go till, you know, like its path is obstructed. And like, as we had seen at the start, placed on an open chessboard with no other chessmen on it, the number of squares available to rook for moving is exactly the same. It is 14. Like, let us just go back to the first position I had shown you, and here we had seen that it has got 14 squares, that is 7 vertically and then 7 horizontally. So same way, like if we place rook on any of the square on an open chessboard, the number remains the same, that is, it has got access to 14 squares. Then coming to the capture with the rook. Well, capturing is the most important aspect of the game. Basically, as we have learned that, you know, game of chess symbolizes a war. It's, you know, fought on a pure warfare method, and we have seen that both sides have got equal armies, that it's 16. And how you can, you know, win the battle, and that is by capturing maximum of your opponent's chessmen. Of course, you cannot capture the king, that we will learn. King can be checkmated, that is the objective. So let us first learn how to capture with a rook. So well, basically the rook captures the opposing chessmen in the same way as it moves. So here you can see, like in this position here, rook is attacking the knight here and also the pawn horizontally and has the option of capturing either of them. So like it's your choice. You have to take a decision. The game does not depend on anyone else's decision, but your own decision. You have to decide what is good for you. So here you have to decide whether it's good for me to capture the knight or capture the pawn. And like the chessmen say here now, for example, if you capture the knight, then the knight is removed from the board. That is, the captured piece is removed from the board and can no longer take part in the game. Thus, the number of chessmen in a game of chess always reduces.